Hey everybody, it's Open Tyler here, and we're back with more poetry. We're going to talk about the three sacred treasures of Japan. We have the Yada no Kagami, which is the sacred mirror. We have the Yasukani no Magatama, which is the jewel. And we have, well, it was originally called the Ami no Murakumo no Tsurugi, which means the heavenly sword of gathering clouds. And it got its name changed to the Kusanagi no Tsurugi, what it is now, which means the grass cutting sword. So basically, we're just going to talk about them today. Which they're also called, besides the three sacred treasures, they're called the Imperial Regalia of Japan. So, I'm just gonna explain the mirror and the Magatama bead was associated when Amaterasu was in a cave, and she locked herself in a cave, and then the light and darkness, her light from the sun, you know, because she was in a cave and gone, everything got dark, and everybody was basically wanted the light back, so they were trying to get Amaterasu out of the cave, and they hung the mirror and the Magatama beads on a tree with Uzume-chan, or Ami no Uzume, basically doing like a sexy dance, basically strip teasing with the stuff hanging on the tree to get Amaterasu to get out of the cave, and she was curious and she got out. And that's how she got out, and she looked at the mirror, and it reflected her beauty, because they were told, like, oh, there's a goddess that's more beautiful than you, Amaterasu, out here. And they were just lying, just trying to get her out, to get her curious. And then she looked at the mirror, and it reflected her beauty back at her, because she was, like, looking at herself. So, that was basically, those are the two that were important with her. And then the Kusanagi became more relevant, as I've already kind of explained before, that when Susanoo killed Orochi, it was actually out of the tail. He cut one of the tails and the Kusanagi came out of the tail, and he gave it the sword to Amaterasu as an apology for what he did before. So, and the reason it was originally, again, called the Murakumo, it wasn't the Kusanagi. The Kusanagi became, like, later for it, because I guess, let me just explain it, read from the actual wiki itself, Wikipedia. Generations later, during the reign of the 12th Emperor Keiko, Ami no Murakumo no Tsurugi was given to the great warrior Namato Takuro as part of a pair of gifts given by his aunt Yamato Haim no Makoto, the shrine maiden of Ise Shrine, to protect her nephew in times of peril. These gifts came in handy when Namato Takuro was lured into an open grassland during a hunting expedition by a treacherous warlord. The lord had fire arrows loosened to unite the grass and trap Yamato Takuro in the field so he would burn to death. He also killed the warrior's horse and befriended his escape. Desperately, Yamato Takuro used the Ami no Murakumo no Tsurugi to cut back the grass and remove fuel from the fire, but in doing so, he discovered that the sword enabled him to control the wind and cause it to move in the direction of his swing. Taking advantage of this magic, Yamato Takuro used his other gift, Fire Strikers, to enlarge the fire in the direction of the lord and his men, and he used the winds controlled by the sword to sweep the blaze toward them. In triumph, Yamato Takuro renamed the sword Kusanagi no Tsurugi, Grass Cutting Sword, to commemorate his narrow escape and victory. Eventually, Yamato Takuro married and later fell in battle against the monster after ignoring his wife's right to take the sword with him. So, that's the reason why it's called that to this day. So, now we're just actually going to get to the poetry part of the video. Woo! So, yeah. Okay. Yada no Kagami, which also is represents wisdom and truth. 8 sides reflects truth, sacred mirror, wisdom, truth, shown Ami's beauty. Amaterasu has a lot of syllables and it's quite the mouthful, and Ami is her name for short, from Akami. So that's why, whenever I say Ami, that means Amaterasu for short for anyone that wants to know. So, and then we have the Kusanagi no Tsurugi, which represents valor, courage, and bravery. Can control the wind, the legend grass cutting sword, Susanoo's gift, sis. We got the Yasukani no Magatama, which represents prevalence, a consideration concern for happiness of other beings. Curved, comma-shaped beads, hung with sacred mirror, tree, to bring Ami out. So, that's all I'm going to do for this video. Everybody, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a great day and a great night. Bye-bye! Woohoo!